All I'm trying to do is toggle the lights all together so that when it gets dark, I can come in here and just simply turn these on. So if we drag these like that, now... Uh-oh. Now I look stupid. What's up, guys? I'm Vortech, and welcome to Mechanica, the game where we are supposed to build, program, and survive. We'll kind of see how that goes. If you enjoy videos like this, don't forget to subscribe, because I want to make more, and I want you to be notified when I actually do that. So what we have here is a desert that we are trapped in, and there's going to be a whole bunch of stuff lying around when we get started. We have a some weird kind of fancy machine, another weird kind of fancy machine, and a lot of questions. So I've been playing a little bit. I know very little, and I can show you what I've learned so far. This right here is iron ore, and we can pick it ourselves with this pickaxe, and we will get chunks of iron ore, like so. And then over here is a smelter. We can actually turn it on. It has fuel in it already. And over here, this weird thing is actually an auto miner. So we don't have to be using a pickaxe, and you can see it just drops the ore out the back. So the first thing I learned about this game while I was sitting here fumbling and bumbling is that these little outputs are actually there for a reason. It doesn't have an inventory because you'll be able to pick things up and then put them right back down. So if we use Q and E, we can rotate, and you'll notice it snaps to the auto miner, the furnace. It's now empty. We picked it up, so let me fill it back up with this fuel. I'm about to show you how cool this game is. And what we can do is turn on the auto miner, turn on the smelter, and every time this gets more than one iron ore in it, it says drop two ores below. You'll see here, in fact, I could probably speed this up by taking what I've already gathered and just tossing it in. It's going to spit up an iron ingot, or steel ingot rather. Blip. Sweet. So, a lot of potential out of the gate for automation. I saw this and I was sold instantly. I'm like, yep, this is my new game. Huge thanks to the dev for sending me an early copy. It'll be out, I think, February 28th on Steam, and the link is down below so you can download it for yourself. But let's see. Let's try to get started here. So what I've just done is gathered up some wheat that was laying around. Again, I did play a few minutes just to learn the lay of the land here. So I've picked up a couple tips that I'll give you guys, and then together we're going to stumble and bumble through our way through the game. One thing you'll notice as I'm planting things is if you've seen a game called Unturned, this may look very familiar to you. It looks familiar to me. The planting box here is reminiscent of Unturned. A lot of the stuff, the gas station, I just have a feeling these developers have played Unturned before, because this, all of it feels like Unturned. So I feel right at home in this game. Okay. Am I being targeted? Hello. All right. I said I feel right at home, and now I don't feel very safe. I don't know. Is this guy hostile? Bop. He is now. Oh, is that a saw blade? Okay. All right. Solve that problem. he drops some things. I picked up an iron ingot, but I didn't get anything else. All right. Looking around, you'll also notice some other machines. This is a... What is this thing? Ah, glass refinery. So it drills for glass. And then over here, we actually need to get this thing going. This actually pumps water. This is a water pump. But neither of these things... Oh, no, this one has batteries. Okay, good. The glass manufacturing thing does not. Here's some blueberries. So I'm actually going to go in here, and this chest is pretty cool. It starts us off with some good stuff. I'm going to put away the wheat and the seeds, but I will grab the batteries and the water, and I'm going to put a battery in this glass refinery like so and turn it on. I'm going to save the other batteries. And whenever this runs out, it runs out. But it's going to very slowly drill for glass or refine sand into glass and spit it out on the ground. We'll come back and get it later. And the reason I'm doing that is because I'm just trying to get things going. So we've planted some wheat. We have glass going. We have water being pumped. Those are very slow processes, and we're going to run out of food and water eventually. There in the bottom left, you can see it. If I open up the cooking menu, we can use the wheat we've already gathered, which is here, to make ourselves some bread. There we go. I'm going to save myself the blueberries. I could have made blueberry muffins, but I don't want to do that yet because I would like to... I was going to say make blueberry seeds. However, it looks like when we picked up the blueberries, it just gave us packs of blueberry seeds. So I've already used the one planter I have on wheat. Should I plant the blueberries nearby? It doesn't look like I can. And it doesn't look like there's room in here anymore. So I guess one of my first tasks is to make a new planter. So those are the survival aspects. Let me show you the programming aspects, because that's probably the coolest part and the most unique thing about this game, because right now I'm treating it like Unturned. You'll notice there's a light switch here. This already works, but if we right-click, if we hold the programming tool and hit E, rather, you can see the program that makes the switch work. There is an event listener, toggle on or off, and then it toggles the light. So basically, a line has been drawn between the lamp and the button, and each of these have their own functions and things like that. But once you link them, you can kind of mix and match functions to get it to do what you want. You know, programming. Now, I am not the person to sit here teaching you about programming, but I am going to show you a few things. I have some basic knowledge of what we can do. I've noticed in my quick run through, there are lights in the ceiling. So what I want to do, because if we turn on the light now, those lights don't come on. So what I want to do is get those ceiling lights to also turn on. So we're going to click and drag these points to these lights. And then now that they're connected, I should be able to go into here and you can see these other lights are now linked. And these lights are really cool. You can change their colors, set their brightness. You can do all kinds of stuff. But all I'm trying to do is toggle the lights all together so that when it gets dark, I can come in here and just simply turn these on. So if we drag these like that, now... Uh-oh. Now I look stupid. Okay, I know what I did wrong. They turn on now. So, be very careful because these menus are very long, and as a result, you may accidentally grab the same toggle light twice, thinking you're grabbing one for each light. I accidentally grabbed this toggle twice, and I was turning on the light toggle twice in a row, which was making not even the first light come on. In any case, we now have a switch that controls all three lights available to us in this lovely gas station. We need to look at the crafting menu because you may remember when I first got here, I left an auto miner on and it's, I think I left it on. I left a bunch of stuff on. It should be spitting up iron ingots as I'm sitting here talking to you guys. And I would like to make one of these storage boxes because I believe that if we put one down where those ingots are being spat out, we will store them safely and soundly. So if we hit tab, we can go to the crafting menu. And we can kind of see things we have. Storage and manufacturing, for example. If we get 4 steel ingots and 2 screws, we can make a new storage box. Now, how do we get screws? Components. Oh, okay, steel ingots. So let me go ahead and do, was it 3? 3 screws? Yep, and now we need 4 ingots. All right, let's go back out there. And it doesn't seem like we need any crafting tables or anything. We can just craft all from the menu at this time, which is cool. We'll run over here, and I did leave this off for some reason. So that was actually kind of foolish of me, because now I have to wait for this thing to mine up iron. But the idea is this output spits far enough to where I feel like I can put a chest right here, and the ingots will just be spat out onto the chest rather than the ground. All right, and I've collected enough stuff to make a storage box. And there it is on this number 2 slot. So I can put it right here. The input is on top, and now let's speed this up again by grabbing some more iron. And, we already did it. It got ahead of me. Here, let me just put this right there. There it goes, clunk. 1 steel ingot. Perfect. So now, as I sit here rambling, we have an automated process for getting ingots. Another thing I want to show you, and you may have saw me earlier grab this axe, we can also chop trees. All that fun stuff. All the basic survival elements are present, which is nice. And I'm willing to bet there's also an automated woodcutter of some sort that comes up later. But I'm going to chop up some logs. I'm going to just spend a little bit of time gathering because I noticed there are a lot of supplies we need for a lot of different recipes, including copper wire. I don't know where copper is yet, So we're gonna do some exploring here in a little bit and try and find some stuff because I want to craft some more machines. It's getting dark, and I think that's what may be spawning these robots who now are alert and aware of my presence. Oh, wow. What is this? Oh, it produces copper wire and circuit boards and batteries, and we better get out of here because we're about to get cornered by robots. Ow. Okay, just doesn't take that many hits, right? Ouch. There we go. Ooh, battery. Nice. All right, I saw another one. I think he lost interest. All right. What is all this? Oh, okay. Oh, I'm guessing I probably shouldn't be breaking those, but what do I do? How do I pick these up? Oh, wait, we right click. That's right. EMP bombs. Oh, okay. Can I pick up this chair? Nice. So can I pick up this machine? Oh my gosh. So we got an auto crafter, we got batteries, we got a storage container. This was just sitting out here. My gas station's right there. Awesome. I don't know if the final release of this game is going to have so many nice little perks just laying around. Maybe these machines aren't craftable yet, and that's why you're able to find them so easily. But yeah, I'm happy with that. We need lithium for batteries, so let me mine up some of this. All right, I found a church sitting out here in the desert. The gas station's way out there now. We've kind of run a ways, and I'm noticing a laser tripwire of some sort. And we got some potatoes, too. I'm stealing these. So if we climb through the window, what's going on here? Look at that. So it's a button that turns the laser on and off. Okay, sweet. All right. I don't know what's hooked up to this laser. Can we find out? Oh my gosh, I would have been smacked in the face with that. I would have been smacked in something with that. It's actually, the spikes are pretty low. Okay, cool. I'm not sure what kind of sadistic church sets this up for its patrons, but I'm taking all of it. This is mine now. Oh my gosh, okay. Really glad I looked. This thing could have saved us from getting, hurt very badly. All right, what else is in here? I'm taking your furniture. It's all on now. We're done. We're done hanging out at the church. I'm taking all this stuff, and I'm leaving. I'm taking these pallets. These are mine. I don't even want to cross the bridge. If a church was strung up like that with traps, do I really want to know? I see an army of robots out there. You know what? And I have my very own trap now, so I have an idea. All right, home sweet home. So I almost got offed by a church, and now I'm upset. But I should be happy because I got some really cool stuff out of the deal. I have this rake trap, that's what's called, and I have a laser tripwire and a button. So I'm going to set up just like they had in the church. All of these things. I'm going to have the laser tripwire down here, where some unwitting robot could potentially trip it. I'm going to have a toggle on it because safety first. Let's put that right there. And let's first connect these two. And if I go into the button, I should be able to... Oh, I could set the button's color. Vents. On button push, laser tripwire will... Let's see. Is there just a toggle? I guess on button push, the laser tripwire will turn on. Uh-oh. I hear a robot, too. Oh, boy. They sound like vacuum cleaners. All right. I need my bat. Yo, the army of robots is here. I did not get that set up in time. That stinks. I was deliberately building this for this very army of robots I spotted out in the distance. So I guess I'll just beat them to death. They're probably going to give me some decent supplies, which is nice. Ouch. Ow. All right, come on. Oh my gosh, this takes so long. Ow. I think they dropped copper, which is good. I haven't found any yet. Come on. Come on. There we go. Nice. I will grab their copper and whatever else they drop. What is this? Is that just an old robot head? Okay. Let's see if we can get a few minutes of peace and quiet here, because I need to figure out this programming stuff. All right, when in doubt, go see if you can cheat off somebody else's work. So this is the tutorial room, and if you hit the button, the door opens and closes. It's the same kind of button. If we go into the programming tool, they use a branch to incorporate a variable. So that's what I was missing. I was trying to figure out how that worked. So if we right click in the middle of this big open programming window and we get this function window that pops up, we can actually find branches in there and put that there. And so what we can do is throw the variable here, the turn on tripwire there, the turn off tripwire there. And I know this looks sloppy, but basically the way this is going to work is we hook all these things up. All right, if true, so on button push, if true, turn the tripwire on, if false, turn it off. I think that's how it's done. So now, maybe I mixed it up. Let's see, we open it up. If true, how do you undo these? Go away. Oh yeah, click on them, hit X. Okay, so if true, turn off, if false, turn on, like that. Hey, I did it. I programmed something. Excellent. So we now can toggle our tripwire trap like so. Let's turn some lights on, even though the sun is coming up. We did program these lights after all. Let's get our rake trap and figure out a good place to put it. I liked it in the ceiling. I think the church had a good idea there. And I think if we just stick it right here at the entrance, that's going to give us the best result. All right, there we go. And if we grab the programming tool, we're going to take the laser and connect it to there. And it should be a very simple program. If we hit E, on laser tripped, okay, rake trap will, let's see. Oh, wait, turn on laser detection. Oh. Well, how to manually trigger trap? That'll probably do the same thing. Maybe. You guys can let me know in the comments how bad I am at programming. All right. So I want to test this, but I also don't want to die. But I mean, I'm getting close to my time here with the video, so... Okay. And it resets itself. That's awesome. I thought I would have to do that. Let's turn that off for now. And if we run into any robots, we can run in here really quick and turn that on, and hopefully they don't jump through windows. 32 steel ingots. So I'm going to turn these off. That was a lot of progress that we made in a very short amount of time. So I want to thank you so much for watching. I do want to play more of this game. And if you want to see more, I'd highly recommend hitting the like button, leaving a comment, and subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. I would greatly appreciate it. I will see you in the next one. Catch you later.